Why can't we do it? Why can't we do it, Kevin? Think about it this morning. Who are you worshiping? Are you worshiping your bosses at work? Are you worshiping the teachers at school? Are you worshiping the playground or the volleyballs or whatever they do in school these days? Who are you worshiping this morning? Did you know that if you worship another God that isn't the true God, that's the same thing as cheating? All of you that's here this morning that's married and got partners and this and that, how many of you have been cheated on throughout the years? How many of you had been hurt because of the cheating? How many other homes have been broken up because of adultery, fornication, and all that stuff? And you know how you felt during that time. Think about God. How he feels when his own creation cheats on him. You may fool Robert from time to time, thinking that you're all together. You may fool Pastor Mark or Bob or people sitting around you, but you ain't going to fool God. You can run to the rocks and the mountains and do your little thing, but God is standing there looking through those rocks, watching you, hearing every word, hearing every thought that's going through your mind and your heart. Put God's shoes on and think about how you would feel. Think about it, Kim. How would you feel if you found out David really wasn't working all the hours that he's working and he's out running around somewhere else? How would you feel? Think about how God feels that his children are cheating on him. You may say, Barb, this is kind of a boring message. That might be boring, our brain, but it's something we need to think about. If you plan to go to heaven, you better start thinking back. The Almighty God, souls and souls and souls has been lost because of that Almighty God. Yes, we got to have it to pay our bills, put food on our tables. But there's a difference between having to have it and worshiping. Just like the rich man and the poor man. Remember that story? Just like them. The rich man had everything, but the rich man, he worshiped his stuff. Wouldn't share. He wouldn't let nobody around his bank accounts and all his jewels and everything he had. And what happened to him? He lost his soul. Why? He wasn't worshiping the right God. Lazarus was a poor guy. Didn't have anything. But I bet if he had a pair of brand new shoes, I bet Lazarus would have gave them to somebody that might need them. What happened to Lazarus? He woke up in heaven. Why? He didn't worship the material things. Even though he didn't have no material things, but what he did have, he still worshiped God. Are you following me just a little bit? The church, all the churches, the Open Door Community Church should be full of people. But the devil put so many traps in front of people to keep them out. But one day, Kim, the Bible tells us it's going to be too late. You can take all your money, you can take all your pearls, silver, gold, diamonds, whatever that you have, and you hide them where nobody can get them. I can guarantee you when you leave this earth, it's still going to be sitting wherever you hid it, because nothing is going to go with you. Not even the clothes on your back is going to go with you. Think about it this morning. Who are you serving? You may say, Robert is the best singer in the world. That he does this, he does that. I've never heard songs done like he does it. Are you worshiping him? Or are you worshiping God while he sings it? Who are you worshiping? Who are you worshiping? I grew up in a church, didn't believe in TVs, didn't believe in this, didn't believe in that. The reason why they would do that stuff is because a lot of times you get so wrapped up in the TV and your Bible is laying there beside you, collecting that dust. Have you ever done that before? I've got like 4 or 5 or 6 Bibles just sitting all around in arm's length. And I'll pick one up that I picked up. I had to wipe the dust off of it. But I'm here today to tell you, don't be tricked out of heaven. Don't be worshiping the President of the United States. Don't be worshiping the First Lady. Don't be worshiping Superman or Batman. Those things are nice to have and to look at and play with from time to time, but it needs to be from time to time. God needs to be every day, 7 days a week. When you go for a walk and look at your neighborhood and look at the pretty trees and flowers, God needs to be holding your hand and taking that walk with you. Like my son, I won't walk without Jesus. Are you walking without him this morning? Think about it this morning. Robert, give us a song. I know I've only preached only about 15, 20 minutes. But I think I've got my point across. Who are you worshiping? Husbands and wives are special. But God needs to come before the husband and wife. Do you know that? Your partners and your kids are special. But God needs to come before the partners and the kids. He's got to be number one. And until you get him number one in your heart and in your life, your situations ain't going to get no better. No matter how much you pray. Do you know that? Who are you worshiping? Are you worshiping the drama? How many people has came across people on Facebook, or you may have them in your family or your neighbors, where their people just ain't happy? Unless there's some kind of drama stirring up. Isn't that worshiping drama? Doesn't God say that he is no author of confusion? So if you're worshiping that drama, you know God's not there. Who are you worshiping this morning? Think about it. I hope this morning that I gave you something to think about. I hope this morning that you heard this and you come back out to his house next Sunday, whether it be here or somewhere else, and have a different view on what God really is. Your money isn't going to pay to get you out of drama or jail or whatever the situation may be. The only one that's going to do that is God. Back out. I want to do it if he's second on the list. How many of you have family issues? I'll be the first one to raise my hands. How many of you has work issues? If you want it fixed, put work down to second place. Move God back up to first place. Then the issues will be solved. Do you know it? He loves you. He made you. He put you on this earth the way he wanted you. You know that? God wanted me short, he wanted me fat. It's okay. He loves me anyway. Bob, he gave you gray hair.
Yeah, with a vengeance.
He loves you. He wanted to look down and see. Well, there's Bob. I can spot him from anywhere. Why did he do that? Because he loves you. Some of you may be here, may be bald. It's okay. He loves you anyway. People might not, but who cares what people think anyway? Amen? Because it's all about what makes God happy. That's what it's all about. Because if you ain't going to make God happy, you ain't going to go to that great city. Because God did. He kicked out angels and everything because of the drama. So what's that tell you? No drama in heaven. No ugly hearts in heaven. Just pure. We all, including myself, need to step up a little bit more. I've got a lot of stuff. You may only have to step a foot out. I may have 5 or 6 feet I need to step up. Keep it real. That's what I do, is keep it real. I make mistakes. I say things I shouldn't say. Keep it real. But as long as we put God first, he's going to help us conquer the areas that we're falling short in. Amen. Why don't we all stand all over the building? If you're here this morning and you want to pray,
and you feel like that maybe it's time for you to step up,
this altar is open. This altar is open.